excavating one of the Crossrail construction shafts right on the edge of Charterhouse Square itself, we came across an amazingly well-preserved archaeological site. 25 burials, buried about 3 metres below the ground level. And this location historically is within the area that we think was associated with one of the emergency burial grounds of the Black Death set out in 1348.
Yeah.
I mean, this site is one of the most important archaeological sites we've got because the period of the Black Death, the mid-14th century, is not well understood through archaeological excavation. It's quite a rare opportunity to find an archaeological site that is so well preserved. It's 1 year on from the excavation work we did. During that time, we've done a series of scientific studies to really try and tie down the results of the excavation. And we've come here today to the Charterhouse, who are very kindly hosting an event so we can present those results, starting with the discovery on the London and the Black Death. A lot of the work that's gone in over the last year has been about understanding the dating initially. And we've done that through dating the finds that we've got associated with the skeletons, but also taking samples from the skeletons themselves to undertake radiocarbon dating. And along with that, the other big question has been, okay, what do these people die of? Are they associated, or can we associate these individuals with the Black Death itself, with the plague? And again, taking tiny subsamples from the skeletons and applying an ancient DNA analysis to those has allowed us to identify the DNA of the pathogen Yersinia pestis, which caused the plague and still carries on today to cause the plague. So these two crucial pieces of evidence we've now kind of nailed down through this analysis work.
Well, first of all, these are a very rare resource. And we don't want to do anything to make them rarer. We don't want to use half the skeleton in scientific testing. We have to be reasonable about if we do any testing, we only take small amounts from the skeletons. So first of all, what we did, we chose half the skeletons and we took one tooth from each of those skeletons. So 12 tooth samples. They can now look at the DNA within ancient bone and tooth and find out what diseases the person was exposed to during life. And then we used the same tooth, what was left from the same tooth, and that was sent off for radiocarbon dating. Stable isotopes are something that accumulate in the tooth from things that a person eats and drinks. And we can use various chemicals, various stable isotopes, to look at where a person grew up. Out of the 10 individuals where we got data back for stable isotopes, 6 of them were actually brought up in London, and 4 of them came from elsewhere. And it's likely that 3 of them came from East or Southern England, and 1 came from the North of England or Scotland.
The area was pretty much open field, so it was a nearby parcel of land owned by the local church, which the kind of London authorities at the time purchased specifically to manage what they expected to be was a devastating plague event. They'd heard about the Black Death creeping across Europe, and this was obviously some kind of premeditated preparation and a very good opportunity to have a precise window into this historical period, which was ultimately probably the most devastating period of London's history. Historic references suggest up to 200 a day were passing down Charterhouse Street to be buried in this area. And extrapolating that over the size of the burial ground, which was stated as something like 13 acres, perhaps 7 hectares, a huge area, huge number of burials that haven't yet been discovered. So the point of the geophysics was to try and see if we can trace more burials in the immediate area and see if we can start extrapolating the numbers up to understand how many are buried in the area still yet to be discovered.